Let's look at question 11. Okay, question 11, it says that this coordinate, negative 4, 8, is the midpoint of the line segment joining P and Q. So it means that I have a line, says that this is P, negative 2, 6, and Q here, which do not have any coordinate. Let's say this is X, Y. And 4, 8 is the midpoint, negative 4, 8 here. So how should I find the coordinate of Q? As we know that midpoint is x1 plus x2 divided 2, you get the midpoint. Alright, same goes to y1 plus y2 divided 2. And in this case, you know that the midpoint is negative 4 and 8. So to get the midpoint, I use negative 2 plus the x here. So divide 2, and same goes to y, 6 plus y, divide 2. And in this case, negative 8 equal to negative 2 plus x, x will be negative 6, okay? Because this is negative 2, bring to here will be positive. 16 equal to 6 plus y, y 16, because 2 bring up to here, it will become times. So 16 minus 6 will be y, y equal to 10. So x equal to negative 6, y equal to 10. So A will be your final answer. Question 12 shows a diagram with a closed cylinder. It says that the area, shaded area down there, is 38.5 cm squared, and the height is 4 cm longer than the radius. Height is 4 cm longer than radius. Alright? So first, to calculate the surface area of the cylinder, you need to know the formula. The surface area of the cylinder, the formula is 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h. Alright, so this is pi r squared because it's the area of the down here, it's a circle. So pi r squared equal to 38.5, so r squared will be 38.5 divided pi. So r squared will give you 12.25. You use calculator, 38.5 divided pi, your pi is 22/7, remember. And r will finally give you square root of 12.25, which is 3.5. So what is height? Height will be 4 plus 3.5, which will be 7.5. In this case, you know that pi r squared is 38.5, so you just times 38.5 because pi r squared is getting from here. Alright, so 2 pi plus 2 pi, 22/7, r is 3.5, and the height is 7.5. So by using the calculator, 2 times 38.5, will give you 77 plus 2 times 22/7 times 3.5 times 7.5, and this will give you 165 cm. So 165 cm plus 77, you will get 224 cm squared. This is the final answer for surface area. Next, diagram 13. So diagram 13 shows a letter of H. So determine the order of rotation, symmetry of the diagram. So what is symmetry? Means that how many symmetry can you do? So if you cut this into half, you can actually fold this in equal size and shape. If you cut this into half, you can actually fold it in equal size and the shape. So it means that you can cut two times. Can you continue cut? Can you cut this way and you fold? You can't fold into the same size. So it means that you can't cut this way. So in conclusion, it only can cut two ways. So answer will be C. So for question 14, a fair dice is rolled. Dice has six faces. What is the probability of getting face with two dots? Two dots means two, all right? In a dice, you can get one, you can get two, you can get three, you can get four, you can get five, also six. How much is the probability of getting only 2? So to get 2, probability of getting 2 is number of getting 2 dy number of sample. So number of getting 2 is only 1 time. So 1 dy number of sample means how many result will be getting from this fair dice. That is 6 result. Alright, so 1 divide 6, the answer will be A here. Question 15 shows a straight line drawn on a Cartesian. Determine the gradient. So to get gradient, there's two formula, y2 minus y1 divide x2 minus x1, or negative y-intercept divide x-intercept. So what is y-intercept? Y-intercept means cut at y. So this is your y-intercept. And cut at x is called as x-intercept. So cut at y is 8, so apply 8. Cut at x is x-intercept over here. So your answer will be negative 4 over 3 if you simplify it by divide 2. So the answer will be A here.